from Washington. This is the Robert Christian Show. Good day, ladies and gentlemen, wherever that you are around the world. We welcome you, and we hope that we are able to enlighten you, give you a little something to think about. And you know what? As a matter of fact, it is perfectly fine. It is acceptable to be a little bit angry. Join the rest of Americans that are angry. But first, ladies and gentlemen, let's take a look at our first news story that we have. And oh my goodness gracious. In an impromptu statement about nuclear weapons, Trump is threatening to append the longstanding U.S. non-nuclear policy, even as his advisors contradict him and muddy his intention. Trump had alarmed and perplexed some experts in the field there in Washington when he announced, without offering any more details via Twitter, he loves Twitter, on Thursday, that the U.S. must greatly strengthen and expand its nuclear capability until such time as that the world becomes or comes to its senses regarding nukes. Oh my heavens. We're going to be getting into that, folks, here in just a few moments. But first, this.
Robert Christian Show, going beyond the news, addressing issues that matter. Join me, the David Bowers, as we begin today's show.
And welcome, ladies and gentlemen, once again, as we are on a quest for equality. We are on a quest for justice. We are on a quest for truth in media. And if you are one of those folks that do enjoy truth in media, you know what, folks? Let us hear from you. Let your light shine, because we need people just like you backing the live shows, joining with us in this. Because you know what? Independent media, that is something that too often is so overlooked and underrated. It truly is, and I want to be able to offer a ray of hope, to offer a truth that people, every time that we go live on the air, that people can get a hold of and at least say, you know what, maybe that did make a little bit of sense. Hey, did you hear about this other news story? I kind of like this news story for a very oddball reason. A creation, don't go away, folks. A creationist theme park in northern Kentucky in the U.S., which claims to feature a full-sized replica of Noah's Ark, has taken advantage of the festive season and to take a swipe at LGBTI communities. And listen to how that they are doing it. In case you missed it, I almost did. The owner of the History Museum, Ark Encounter, Ken Ham, posted on a blog entry with details of the park's seasonal celebrations. Our special Christmas event, he said. At the Ark Encounter, he said, today. Actually, no, it was last week when he said this. And he said that they have added a wow factor. I like this. Do I have your attention yet? A wow factor. We have lit the whole Ark in beautiful rainbow colors. It's gorgeous at night. Explaining why that they have chosen to light the Ark with rainbow colors, Ham says, in quotation, now most people, even vaguely familiar with the Genesis flood, account. Know that the rainbow is associated with the ark. After the flood, God, his God, made a covenant with Noah and his family and their descendants, and to the living creatures on the ark. The sign was the covenant was of a rainbow. So he is deciding on his own to light up Noah's ark with rainbow colors. Lovely and delicious. Thank you for remembering the LGBTI community that too often have been shoved aside, thrown under the bus in the name of religious bigotry. Enough is enough. Speaking of oddball things, here is another oddball. North Carolina's House Bill 2 lives on, says North Carolina. A day after the public debate and behind closed doors during a special session of the General Assembly, the state's Senate voted down on the promotion to repeal the controversial so-called bathroom bill or House Bill 2. This vote took place after the House adjourned without making a decision. The crowd inside of the Senate chamber shouted and chanted shame as the legislative body adjourned. A plan by North Carolina Republicans, note it does not say Democrats or independents, but a plan by North Carolina Republicans to repeal the state's sweeping anti-LGBTI measure ran afoul with Democrats who charged that they had re-engaged on a promise of a full appeal of HB2, of which no vote was taken. HB2, or House Bill 2, forces transgender people to use the bathroom matching their gender at birth and strips cities of the right to pass anti-discrimination ordinances protecting LGBTI people. This has badly damaged the state's reputation and it has hurt North Carolina's economy. And now for the funsie. I didn't say Fonzie, the funsie. Donald Trump's inauguration. Ugh. Now that, you know what, I almost now need a gargle. But this parade, this circus, will be far from a star-studded event. But that doesn't matter to Trump. After several celebrities publicly turned down offers to perform at the circus on January the 20th, Trump tweeted that he doesn't want A-list guests anyway. A-list celebrities. Okay. But here is a coincidental offering. And we're going to get into this. The so-called A-list celebrities are all wanting tickets to the parade and to the circus. There on January the 20th in Washington, D.C. But look at what they did for Hillary. Nothing. I want the people. He tweeted this on Thursday night, referencing how many of Hollywood supported Hillary Clinton. Stars that were invited to the Trump escapade, the Trump circus, with the official clown car circling the block and making a quick right. And hurry. But some of the stars that said no to Trump, but yet were invited by him and or by his people, were Sir Elton John, David Foster, Garth Brooks, Kiss, Celine Dion, Motley Crue, Ice-T, and the list, of course, goes on and on. Meanwhile, the New York City, Radio City Music Hall, Rocketeers. Anyway, they are not happy at all with having no choice in the matter but to go to this circus. Apparently, it is not their choice as much as that it is the choice that was handed down to them by the union that supports them, or by the union that helps to protect them. So more or less, they are given the idea. They're given this, saying that if you don't show up at this clown car circus, the biggest and the best, with no name brand celebrity A-lists. But if you don't show up, guess what? It could be your job. Meanwhile, back at the ranch, there are many protests of which that are being formed and planned around the January 20th date on the calendar. Now, here on the Robert Christian Show on January the 20th, we are going to be having a dear friend of ours that we've had, he's a good guy. We've known him for many years, but it'll be his first time on. And so we're going to be welcoming Drew, and we're going to be talking about this entire fiasco. We are going to be looking at what to expect in the future when it comes to this up and coming Trump. Now, you know what? I'm not, and I will make it very publicly, make a very public statement. That as far as I'm concerned, he never will be called President Trump. Not in my vocabulary. My system would malfunction. But he will be referred to as Trump. Because the moral of it is, and as I understand it, what it is this. That it's either that you are for the American people and you are going to unite the American people. You are going to lead them into a path of recovery, a path of solvency, a path of freedom, a path of hope. Or you're going to lead people then in a path of division by calling and by naming ethnic groups, including Mexicans, including, Muslims. And making specifically those two groups, the guinea pig of hate. Ladies and gentlemen, there has to come a time in American history where we rise up above that. Unfortunately, I don't see that America has risen above that bigotry and that hatred. Now, why is that so paramount and prominent today? Good question. You know what, after having 8 years of President Obama, I never have looked at him in this sense as anything but our president. Now, I know that there are some folks that live in the deep South that forever and ever will absolutely hate President Barack Obama because he happens to be African-American. There have been those who have tried to obstruct him, i.e. Congress, i.e. the U.S. Senate. So I'm hoping, really, in a strange way, but I'm hoping that Congress and the U.S. Senate will be so willing to work with Trump. identically as that they were President Obama. Folks, the moral of it is that Trump, he doesn't have all of the answers. Of course, he never said, in quotation, "I know all of the answers." He said, "I know the big words." He says, "Bigly." I know the big words, and bigly, we're going to make America great again. Look, you can't make America great again as long as that you are continuing to harm Americans, as long as that you are trying with the Republicans to dismantle the mantelpieces of which that America has stood for and America takes great pride in. Now, I can understand wanting to do something with Obamacare. Trust me, I can understand that. I can understand needing a change in that. But guess what? I've said that for years. I think that Obamacare, or the Affordable Care Act, that it was a step in the right direction, but not necessarily the best step that needs to and should have been taken. What it did not do was it did not rein in the cost of prescription medication. It did not rein in the cost that hospitals and doctors are able legally to charge patients. Healthcare benefits being cut left and right and center because of Obamacare, because of loopholes within it. These things I've already outlined them. I've already said what these things are. Now, quiet as is kept, the Republicans are right in this in this sentence that they want to change Obamacare. But the changes to Obamacare, that is, you know, hook, line, and sinker, what are they? What are these changes? They are not saying what these changes are. A lot of folks that are on Social Security, a lot of folks that depend on Medicare or Medicaid, a lot of folks that depend on food stamps, a lot of people that are disabled or seniors, they're going to be feeling the pinch of Trump. Meanwhile, the rich billionaire class, of which all of his cabinet choices so far are either billionaires or at the minimum millionaires. There's a reason for that. It appears that Donald Trump doesn't want to deal with people that are poor or people that don't have any kind of idea as to what money actually is. Look, it's not a matter of money or how much money that somebody has. It's dependent on how smart that they are or how many bigly words that they use. Wow, could you imagine becoming a multi-billionaire just for saying the word bigly? I know all the bigly words. Hey, that's worth $1 million. That's worth $1 billion right there. I know the best words. I know big words. That's what he said. Remember that? So it appears to me that we are now faced with an absolute dilemma. Oh, my goodness. And hello, Joe from South Jersey. The A-list celebrities, I love this. I love his rant. So the A-list celebrities are all wanting tickets to the inauguration. But are they really, Donald? But look at what they did for Hillary. Nothing. I want people. To me, I think that really, really, really what's going on is that he might want people. But guess what? They're going to be on the other side of the fence. Ouch. I'm Robert Christian, and we'll be back with more of the Robert Christian Show right after this. Hey folks, we are back. Welcome to the Robert Christian Show. If you are new to the live shows, hey, we welcome you. We are happy. We're happy to at least make our small little part of the world maybe a little bit better, and encourage and enlighten all of our viewers. One moment at a time. That's exactly where it is. Okay, folks, we are going to change gears here just a little bit and talk about nuclear weapons and these nuclear arms races, of which that now seems very apparent that it is on the horizon. You know, I said years ago, this is the deal, that mankind are creating weapons of destruction for a reason. Not just to sit there and look at them, put them on the mantle, put them in a cabinet somewhere. But there again, we find a lot of people, when it comes to nuclear weapons, and you immediately think of nuclear war. And if you said that, if you feel that way, well, chances are you're right. Now, I think that no matter what happens with with Trump's ideas, preparation with more nuclear. Now look at this, folks. Just look at this. What happened in Japan with the Fukushima power plants that were destroyed because of the hurricane? Well, not the hurricane, but the earthquake. And we now know that, and it's no tip-top secret, that the radiation has infiltrated the Pacific Ocean, and the radiation from the fallout has actually now reached officially the west coast of the United States. Now, that alone should be scary. That alone should be frightening. But now let's go back a little bit further in time, and let's look at World War I and World War II. Let's focus a moment's attention on the Korean conflict and the Vietnam War. Haven't Americans learned something from those experiences? Maybe to some, yes. But look, our democracy is very frail. Our democracy in America, it is just as frail as that you can potentially make it, this side of Trump declaring himself as a dictator. Now, will that happen? I don't know. I would doubt it, but I would say doubt it loosely. Now, I am not, trust me, I'm not a fan of Trump. I'm not a fan of his policies, because this is not the biggest reality television episode or series that the world has ever seen. This is not that. the A-list of billionaires and millionaires serving in his makeshift cabinet only proves one thing, that money talks. We've all heard the expression, money talks, but beep, 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 right? That walks. The bottom line, ladies and gentlemen, is that we are faced right now with a very dangerous dilemma. I know that there are calls for him to be impeached moments after that he takes the oath of office. We've heard the news that his wife does not have plans on living in the White House or moving to D.C., and that Trump himself has plans to only live there or only be there part-time. And then there was a battle of sort over his children being in the White House and being accessed or accessible to these high-end meetings that often goes on between presidents and world leaders. And then we have the deal, perhaps, that there is a lot of conflict of interest that surround him. You know what? Americans knew this going in. People knew, and trust me, they did. They understood. They knew what was going on as it was happening. And they were like, yes, hey, we want this guy to be the next occupant of the White House. We wanted a Trump White House. We've got to get rid of the black guy. We don't want Barack Obama in there anymore. And here people then are throwing around the race card and saying, you know what, I don't like Obama and all this. Oh, look at what he's done, or look at what he hasn't done. Look at Obamacare. That was a fiasco farce to begin with. Let's look at all of the bad and all the evil ibby-jibbies. Let's focus our attention on those things, because that is what people are so frustrated with. And I'm like, really? Really now? Because I would guarantee you within 3 years that the approval rating, and they always have these, the approval rating then of Trump is going to be in the single digits. I could imagine. I could just about imagine. I could just about imagine that there would be threats globally. And suddenly we have somebody in the White House that says one thing but yet does completely the opposite. Now, is it me or is it me? Now, look, ladies and gentlemen, I am here to not bargain with you, not to make a fuss, but rather to raise your eyebrows just a little bit and make you think. I think that the dumbing down of America has begun, and it's in full swing. I think that the division, and for those of you that remember, just a few years ago, folks, hey, I was in the TV studio. And you know what? I said then that one day, and what I saw, and as I remember, it was when George W. Bush Jr. Was taking the office of there in the White House, of which I never did call him president, and I still won't either. Not to this day. Speaking of former presidents, just sort of FYI, but sort of an interesting notation, that every former president that is living in the United States has been invited also to this fiasco flytrap. But only one of them has said yes, that he would be happy to attend. Jimmy Carter. Now, I do adore him. I think that Jimmy Carter was a great guy. He was a reasonable president for the time. He was soft-spoken. He knew where he wanted to go. He knew what America needed. And for the time, at least, he showed wisdom, finesse, and gratitude. And now here we have somebody that obviously and already has made comments that he wants to rebuild our nuclear capability and the nuclear arsenal and factories and storage facilities, etc. But then he fails to understand this, I guess. Because America, we spend 57% of the national economy every year. The national budget, 57% of it, every year on military. We should not be spending that much. No other country on this earth spends that much. I could see 40% or 45%. That would be max. But 57%, that is absolutely insane. Now, historically, every time that America has gone to war, our economy has flourished. Except with the war that George Bush started. And now generations of families have been destroyed as a direct result of it. Ladies and gentlemen, something has to give. And I'm not talking about your pocketbook. We'll be right back. All right, folks. Hey, we are back. And I am actually scouring here just a moment on the air while I'm sitting here. Scouring over some other streams to see if there's anything right now that I can show you. Live, but it appears like that there is nothing, really, nothing available that I can show you. Otherwise, hey, I would definitely take a break and show everybody, some of the stuff that's going on. Now, so I want to, again, folks, I want to focus attention on protesting, a healthy protest versus a very unhealthy one. And you know what? I was reminded earlier today, wow, talking about a flashback. You know, I was taken back when I watched live a protest rally that was going on in London. The police department in London, when it came to the protesters, you know what they were doing? They were saying, hey, if anybody, we need to disperse the crowd first and foremost. But the police officers were saying, if you are disabled, let us know. We will help you to get out of the area. We are dispersing the crowd. If you're new to the area, welcome to London. We're dispersing the crowd. There was not one gun that was shown, not one rock, not one that was thrown. It was not necessarily a battle of words, but there was respect on both sides, respect by the protesters and respect by the police department. Now, again, and nobody was hurt during that event in London. Now, what is the problem? What is the, and I love that. Oh my God. I was talking to somebody, a viewer, a visitor in our chat. In our live chat, about it. And we are back with the Robert Christian Show. Okay, folks, we are focusing a little bit of our attention today on the idea. And, you know, a lot of people are very afraid of this, and for good reason. Now we know that having a hothead behind the Mighty POW button, behind the switch, having access to the codes and the systems that are, one mistake and it's all over. One mistake. Now, folks, this is really causing a conflict of interest. That in itself, wouldn't you say? It's causing a conflict of interest where the American populace are now faced with a dilemma. And maybe some are saying, you know what, I want my vote back. Let me go there a minute. Let me go there just a second. The bottom line is that I went on a social media site the night before the election. And I had made comment then. I said, you know what? We know what's going on. We know what is happening in the world, and we know that one candidate actually did get more votes on the popular vote than the other by millions. But I asked then, would you, if you have voted early, would you want your vote back? And you know what? There was a lot of comments about it. A lot of people said yes. A few said no. They still support. They still support the idea of one man. Meanwhile, he's filling his cabinet with millionaires, at a minimum, billionaires at a maximum. Filling office space with family members that have no right to be in those offices, and for what reason? They have no reason to be in there, having their own offices, having their own staff, having their own deal. There is no, what's the logistical purpose for that? That's what I would want to know. But when he pronounced and announced offering more details via Twitter, he loves the Twitter, yesterday, that the U.S. must greatly strengthen and expand its nuclear capability until such time that the world comes to its senses regarding nukes. Okay, so everybody else is wrong. Your thought, I hate to tell you, your thought is wrong. Your approach to things are wrong. Wrong. Your idea on nuclear weapons, wrong again. So until everybody else gets as smart as he is with the bigly words, right? The biggest words, he knows how to do this using all of the bigly words. I love that, right? So until such time that the world, i.e. America, i.e. those that do not support him, or those that don't like him for whatever reason, until they come to their senses, because after all, they are the ones who are senseless. Bless God and the GOP. They are the ones who are senseless. But until such time as that they wake up, and as such time until they discover that he is the impending dictator, the plan is to strengthen and to expand nuclear capabilities. Until such time as the world comes to its senses regarding nukes. You know what? I think that we should look no further than who is going to be going into Well, the White House. Trump himself. When it comes to understanding and coming to a sense regarding nuclear weapons and nuclear war, I think America gets it. I'm sure of it. I'm sure that hey, perhaps Russia, they get it. I'm sure, more than sure, that China gets it. The thing of it is, we don't have to be the bully on the block. And ladies and gentlemen, that is exactly what has happened in the past, and that is exactly what is going to happen in the future. Watch and see. Folks, I've said this over and over and over and over. Watch and see. Because, look, if it's not bad enough that we have a man that is going to be taking the oath of that office, which, in my opinion, he should be deprived of, really. That should be taken away from him. But this, that is part of the problem. The other part of the problem are the conditionary conditions upon a condition, because of a condition, has now become the planks of the GOP crumbling platform, of which that they don't understand that it's crumbling around them, but what's happening is that it is causing great fear and distress in America, and we simply do not need that. Now you say, well, Robert, I don't like you anymore. You're too progressive. No, I'm anti-war. Because, you know what, war happens because two people do not get along. And guess what? Every war that has ever happened in the history of this world, watch this, it has happened because of a political maneuver, but because of a religious one. Every one of them. Well, we don't want Muslims in our country. Really? I would prefer to have a neighbor that is Muslim than I would have a neighbor that is full of hate, full of anger, and somebody that, well, are within one of these fringe groups that support an idiot. That's what I would prefer. I would rather have a Muslim family living next door and get to know them, get to know their culture, get to know their thoughts and their feelings. Guess what? That would not make me afraid. What makes me afraid? What makes me angry, I guess, to a point, is to find out how stupid that America has become. The electorals, yes, they had the opportunity. A once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Catch it. Watch this. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know about you, but I'm tired of the GOP crap. I'm tired of the GOP mumbo-jumbo wherein they think that, oh, guess what? It, you know, it's our way or the highway. Well, we're finding out what the highway is, and it's a highway that is paved with horrible intentions that are leading right to the pit of hell. Now, are you still going to argue that point? Again, folks, the problems that America has are not Democratic, nor are they Republican. They are American problems. And what it is going to take is American ingenuity. It is going to take Americans with a solid frame of mind. It is going to take people like you, people like me, to help to change the world, even one person at a time. Now, why people have chosen to turn a deafened ear to it, and they prefer to deal with an idiot, and that's beyond me. So now it's not just nuclear war, of which that is now being the weapons are now, I guess, on order or soon to be. the order of the day. Let's get ready. It's not just that, but it is an attack on Social Security. It is an attack on Medicaid and Medicare. It is an attack, believe it or not, on our military, on our veterans. Love the soldier, but hate the veteran. How about those cran apples? How about that for size? Ladies and gentlemen, if you ask me, that is completely repulsive. I'm repulsed. I get angry because I see what's going on in America, but very few are willing to stand up and be counted. Very few are saying, wait a second, this is the beginning of a new revolution. And you know what? If this, what we're talking about today, if this is what we call a new revolution, I don't want no part of that. We can all agree that we need to have change in Washington, but let's look at this just a little bit, shall we please? It is a Congress that has refused to do their job, yet they continue to vote for their own pay raises. This last year, they've taken far more dates on the calendar off as vacation days than any other Congress ever in the history of America. They also have the lowest approval rating of any Congress ever. Why are these yahoos still in office? Because it is the stupidity of America that continues to put these idiots in office. Look, I call it the way I see it. They're idiots. They are blooming freaking idiots. They have refused to work with President Barack Obama. Look, like it or not, take it or leave it, that's it. They have refused. They have refused to work. They have refused to do what they were sanctioned and called to do by the voter. And now here we have the Electoral College again. And they, yes, they had the opportunity to stand up and say, no, we're not doing this. I'm going to vote with my conscience. No. They voted as if they were paid to vote a certain way. For a specific candidate in mind, all I have to do is vote for this guy. Whoops. And suddenly, hey, I can be bought off. Sure, why not? Hey, it's a money-making opportunity. No. You know what? It is a history-making opportunity. And they had the opportunity to change the vote, to change the entire situation, and to completely turn this election cycle on its ear. But they didn't do it. They didn't have the comeuppance. Ladies and gentlemen, look, it's not that I hate the Republicans. I don't like what they do. I don't like what they have stood for at all. And it's not that I'm just a hard-nosed Democrat. No. I am progressive, and I kind of like that. I'm left of center and unbalanced. Hey, welcome to the club. But you know what? I look at both sides of every news story. I look at both sides of every candidate filling and soon to fulfill this office. And it doesn't necessarily make me happy. Again, what I see and what I have known is that America, it is crumbling. I'm not talking about its infrastructure. I'm talking about its political mayhem and the political aspect of this whole thing. It's causing a lot of fear. It's causing a lot of problems. So I don't know about you, but I am not going to be attending the circus, the year-end circus. I'm not going to be watching the clown car go screeching around the corner, right, with the clown heads going out the windows. I'm not going to be looking for the clowns along the side of the road that is throwing bubblegum into the crowd and offering cotton candy and all of this jargon stuff. I don't know of anybody that is going to be offering Trump bobbleheads at this circus either. I don't know of anybody that's going to go. Meanwhile, the A-list celebrities that were, in fact, invited have said, nope, we're not going to go. Thanks for the invite, but I'm not going to. I'd rather keep my fans in tow, and I would rather keep my comeuppance. I would rather do that than sit there and show, no, not doing it. And I'm glad they're not. Folks, speaking of, hey, I hope you all are catching this, but speaking of, the 20th of January, our dear friend Drew is going to be joining us, and he is quite politically motivated, but he's going to be joining us for a live show. It'll be his first time. Folks, look, I've been in media for well over 30 years. And Drew is sort of one of those people that are a rare find, much less a rarer friend. And because he's able to share with me some of his thoughts, some of his ambitions, some of his ideas when it comes to the world of politics. And you know what? He's preaching to the choir. But you know what? A lot of folks, though, are so arrogant. A lot of people are so agitated when it comes to the world of politics. They vote completely party line. No matter what the candidate is, as long as he has Republican, bless God, in front of his name, he has to be a good guy because you say, yeah, you say. All right. See there. So no matter what he stands for, no matter what, as long as he's Republican, that's all that matters. I love that. Am I still going to be imitating Mitch? Yeah. I will, as long as that he's there. So to answer that question, yes. But, I mean, come on, folks. I try to have fun. I do, and I try to make people see things maybe a bit differently. The thing of it is that for those seniors and for the disabled, who voted for this man, your vote more or less said, I don't want my Social Security. I don't need it. I don't need my disability benefits. We don't need to eat. We don't need health care. So go ahead and take away the Medicare and the Medicaid programs. We don't need that either. You know, come on. What's the use? All of these other things, we don't need them. Hey, I'm going to vote for this guy. And, oh, yes, I would rather have wartime than peacetime. I would rather have the billionaires or multi-billionaires getting their tax breaks than me getting my help that I need for my home or the veterans. You may be a veteran. You may be in the military. Thank you for your service. But the bottom line is that one of the planks or one of the ideas of that knucklehead is this, that he wants to privatize the VA. I'm completely against that because the veterans of our country, they did not go to fight a war on behalf of a company or because and for an oil company, or did they? They went and they fought and they gave their life. To protect America and its democracy, to protect America and its freedom. From all enemies, foreign and domestic. That is, in part, the oath that they take. So to privatize the VA and VA healthcare, bad move. Bad, very bad move. I think what is lacking here is that because the U.S. spends 57% of its national budget every year on military, first, America is being ripped off. The health care for our veterans is paramount. They have earned it. The education, the higher education for our veterans is paramount. They have earned that. And to say that there should not be one veteran that is homeless in the United States of America. Some gave nothing and gained billions, while others gave it all and gained nothing. Do you see the point? Folks, is that progressive? Is that too progressive for you? If it is, guess what? You don't have to watch me. You don't have to tune into the live shows. I would prefer that you didn't. But I am here to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, that being progressive, being Democrat, or being Republican, that's not even the ticket. That's not the real issue. The real issue is not what political party do you belong to. The real issue on the ticket here is, what do we do with our veterans? Do we help them? Do we sanction money and health care for them as it is, and increase this? What about the Pentagon budget? Oh my goodness. Billions of dollars, right? What about that? Yeah, what about that? What about those apples? What about the seniors that are on Social Security? What about those people? What about the disabled? Oh, they don't matter. Well, they voted for you, did they not? Well, they don't matter, so, you know, hey, they voted for, they knew exactly what they were voting for when they were going into this. Folks, look, wake up. And I want you to wake up, because I have said the exact same thing over and over and over and over when it comes to this election, when it comes to this candidate. I've told everybody what this guy was up to, what his platform was, what his dream to make America so great again. I've told everybody. The horrible thing of it is, has mainstream media ever contacted me as a result of some of my comments? No. What about any other LGBT publications or newspapers or magazines? Have they? No. But yet then we find people that are starving. We find people that are hurting. Where is the justice to help these people and to help to bring closure from a society at large that could care less? Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know about you, but I do care. This is the Robert Christian Show. Visit us on the web, ladies and gentlemen, robertchristianshow.com. Get ready, ladies and gentlemen, for hour two upcoming here on the live shows. And we will be back, folks, right after this.